Yeah,
he's making me that idiot.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, folks.
How are you? Salaam alaikum. Wa alaikum salaam.
How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
How are you?
What is it? What is it? MIC3.
No. MICT. Technology at the end.
MICT3.
Attorney General and Minister of Justice. It's my pleasure to now call this program to order. And as usual, we usually invoke the presence of God whenever we have such occasions. And this is where I'll invite a member of the Interreligious Council of Sierra Leone to lead us in Muslim prayers.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, we thank you, Allah. All praises belong to you, Allah, the legislator of all the divine human rights enshrined in Islamic constitution, the glorious Quran. We thank you, Lord, Lord of mankind and being, for all you enabled our head of state, government, and people of our country to realize so far in the political, social, and economic development of our nation. We pray, Allah, for all our national and international peers in our strides in building a united and cohesive nation. For you commanded us, saying, "What shall we do with Bamri? Fain Azamta, Fatawaka Allah, in Allaha, you people, Mutawaki, and consult them in affairs? Then, when you have taking a decision, put your trust in Allah. Certainly, Allah loves those who put their trust in Him. We pray, Allah, for members of our Constitutional Review Committee. Our head of state is here to officially launch on behalf of his nation. May they have your fairness, Lord. And may they be mindful of you in the discharge of their functions. Transform us, Allah, from the culture of hate and envy, political intolerance, to that of mutual love and respect, commitment and willingness to live and work with one another for peaceful coexistence that will lead us to prosperity. May the law for our country be supreme over groups, factions, regions, and tribes. Abdullahi mina shaitan rajim. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, kunu qawamina bilqist, shuhadaa lillahi walaw ala anfusikum, aw lilwalidayni wal aqrabin, in yakun ghaniyan aw faqiran, fallahu a'la bihima. Fala tattabi'u al-hawa an ta'dilu, wa in tawlu aw tuwilu. O you who believe, stand out firmly for justice as witnesses to Allah, even as against yourselves or your parents or your king, and whether it be against rich or poor, for Allah can best protect both. Follow not the lust of your heart, lest you avoid justice. And if he distort your witness or refuse to give it, verily Allah is ever well acquainted with what you do. Join me in reciting the Al-Fatiha. I will be the Al-Fatiha. Bismillahi Rahmani Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmani Rahim. Maliki Yawmi. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
Thank you very much, Sheikh Abu Bakar Konde. And I invite a counterpart from the Interreligious Council as well to lead us in Christian prayers.
Will you stand with me?
Honor of the mighty God. Let us pray. O Lord God, Father of creation, we acknowledge your presence in our midst this morning, because your word says, wherever two or three are gathered in my name, yea, I am in their midst. And whatsoever they shall agree, when the two or three of them meet, it will be also agreed upon in heaven. And whatsoever they agree to lose here on earth shall also be loosed in heaven. So, Almighty God, our Father in heaven, we are honored to return sincere thanks and appreciation to you for the gift of life and this wonderful day, and for enabling us all together on this very historic occasion for the official launching of this, of the Constitutional Review Committee. Men and women of integrity, noble character, and professionalism have been prayerfully and thoughtfully selected to spearhead this sacred and honorable task on behalf of over 6 million people and even generations yet unborn. We therefore reckon the daunting nature of this important task in the hands of this small but formidable group of distinguished personalities who have to review, restructure, and revitalize a very important and sacred document, the Constitution of Sierra Leone, to meet the expectations of all and sundry. Our Father in heaven, we therefore pray for divine direction, personal commitment, and a sense of direction for all members. May the final document stand the test of time. We pray also for inner strength, a sense of purpose from all members. Our Lord and God in heaven, we pray that when this document is finally completed, it will not only be acceptable to all, but will be heralded by thousands and millions as one of the nation's success stories. Lord, we know that we may produce an excellent document, but our human frailties may hamper the workability of this Constitution without your intervention. Therefore, we pray for a change of attitude, that when the final document will have been produced, it will enhance the nation's cohesiveness. We pray, Father, that at the end of the day, our dream for a cohesive, progressive, united and prosperous nation will be accomplished. We crown you chairman of this entire process and this very important occasion in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. God bless you.
Mr. Bokari, please.
Thank you very much, Mr. Verity. The Lord Chief Justice, the Mayor, Faith and City Council, Cabinet Ministers, Honorable Members of Parliament, our traditional Paramount Chief, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. But with a distinguished audience like this, I ask myself, does it need any formal introduction? An audience graced by distinguished Paramount Chiefs, our market women, I'm sure with the leave of His Excellency, I'll dispense with a formal, traditional way of introducing the chairman of such occasion. It is my pleasure, His Excellency, to introduce to you the chairman of this occasion. He's no other person but the Honorable Alhaji Alpha Kanu, Minister of Information and
thank you very much, Mr. Abdullahi Perete, Coordinator on Outreach. Publicity in the Office of the Government Spokesman. Your Excellency, President of the Republic of Sierra Leone, President Ernest Bai Koroma, Honorable Vice President of the Republic of Sierra Leone, Alhaji Abubakar Siddiq Samsumana, Honorable Ministers, Honorable Members of Parliament, I beg your pardon, the Lord Chief Justice of the Republic of Sierra Leone, Alam Haja Umu Awa Tijan Jal, Honorable Ministers, honorable members of parliament, my lords and ladies, the mayors of our municipalities, Freetown, Bo, Kenema, Makeni, and Bournemouth, our traditional rulers who are here, the Attorney General and Minister of Justice who has convened this meeting today, my Ombudsman, Justice Kanoni Cowan, all members of the High Table, including the ERSG, Mr. Jens Stolberg. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It is today a momentous occasion because we are gathered here today to discuss our nation's good, how we want to be in the future. We have been before, but we believe that we can be better human beings and better peoples beyond today. That is why we are here. The history of constitutions started when King John of Great Britain and Lord of Ireland lost the support of his barons and lords due to the litany of lost battles with the French, which resulted in the loss of Normandy and Gascony, the only possessions Britain had in the European mainland, leaving them with the outer isles of Shetland Islands and the Channel Islands. They surmised that the losses were due to the fact that the king was an absolute monarch. He was taking decisions, spending money, financing campaigns, and I believe King John lost all battles. But because they had respect for their monarchy, they decided to bring him to the table so that they can draw up what we now know as a constitution, so that the people whom he is ruling also have a way of putting together the conditions under which they must be ruled. That's the basis of conditions, of a constitution. So King John was forced to sign an agreement, which is called the Great Charter, and in Latin it's called the Magna Carta, on 15th August 1215. That indeed, 800 years ago, was the beginning of constitutional documents. To a large part, the larger part of the British constitution today revolves around the Magna Carta. Everything else is an add-on from tradition and local folklore and customs. That is why Britain is said to have not to have a written constitution, because the Magna Carta was written in 1215 and survives to this day. It also formed the nucleus around which the American Constitution was built. And I believe that when Britain, in 1800s, declared a protectorate, then for the rest of Sierra Leone, I think it's in 1887, that constitution became the working document for legislature in Sierra Leone. Not until 1951, when the British decided they were going to introduce a legislative council to allow some of our Africans to sit in the legislature, that another constitution was drafted and signed. This was superseded in 1957 by another constitution which gave us the title, our leader, the title of Chief Minister, and Sir Milton Augustine Stribe Magai became the first and only Chief Minister that we have in Sierra Leone. By 1961, the constitution was further amended to take into consideration the fact that Sierra Leone was now going to be an independent nation. So the independence constitution was written in 1961. In 1967, a moment of history here, Sir Albert Magai was Prime Minister of Sierra Leone. He introduced a bill in Parliament which was referred to as the One Party Bill. That bill passed through its first, second, and third reading. Sorry, first, second reading, went into the legislative committee. Well, in the intervening period, the elections came. And Albert Magai's party, the SNP, lost that election. There was an interregnum when we had the military coming. In 1968, Sir Dr. Shaka Probing Stevens was declared Prime Minister. And he inherited the 1961 Constitution, which continued until the introduction of the Republican Constitution in 1973, which effectively delinked us from the monarchy in Great Britain. That was the time we dropped the Magna Carta as an instrument for legislature in Sierra Leone. In 1978, working on the encouragement of Sir Albert Magai, who in 1967 had tried to introduce a one-party system in the country. Dr. Shaka Stevens thought that this would be a good thing to do because at the time, when he became Prime Minister, his government was a coalition government. It comprised of the SNPP and the APC. So if we are